Hey everybody, this is Vril. Welcome back to Extended Timeline New World Order. So in the last episode, we had a war between Brazil and Peru, and you can see here, Peru really took a pretty large chunk of Brazil there. So between Peru and Brazil, we'll see who ends up taking over the South America here and winning. Now over in Europe, we had a Polish war against Belarus. Poland had a bunch of allies, and they cut down Belarus, giving some of the territory Belarus had taken from the Russians back. So Belarus really cut down to size. Now, Egypt lost a war against Ethiopia here, so not looking good for Egypt. I thought they would be strong. We had Niger taking over, basically splitting Nigeria here. And we also had India going into Iran, taking over, several provinces on the Iranian-Indian border here, which used to be Pakistan here that the Indians had taken already. So looking at the wars that we have going on, let me just get to that. We have the second Panamanian nationalist war that will probably be over really quickly. We have an Argentinian-Chilean war, so a lot going on. South America, we have an Equa-Guinean-Nigerian imperialist war. Probably going to lose to Nigeria and Mali there, and Kenya and Sudanese nationalist war. So let's go ahead, get things started. Head down to Argentina and see what's going on here. Although a lot of the times when we start, you can see that Argentina's really lost out a lot of territory so far in this series. And what I was about to say was that a lot of times these wars start and then they immediately end as soon as I start the time. So let's just see what's going on. We'll keep checking back. Okay, we've got, I know you guys love these, we've got the USA going into Mexico once again. So that's I guess that truce has probably been, is over now. So at the same time, the Mexicans are going into Panama, which I actually said was a good strategy for them to try to escape the American onslaught from the north in Mexico. But it's not looking very good. I think that the Mexicans did a little bit better job defending against the Americans in the World War II series. If you guys remember, they actually escaped to Cuba, taking over Cuba at one point. Although, in the very, very final episode, the Cubans actually had an uprising and they came back. So, yeah, I don't think the Mexicans... Oh, we'll see. They actually put up a good fight last time they had this war. They have a pretty good army, but obviously they're dealing with Panama here. I mean, considering it's Mexico, they have a pretty good army. Obviously, they're not going to do much against the 200K that the Americans have in northern Mexico here. So while we do that, let's see, anything else? We have an Indian change of government in Sri Lanka. We'll see if the Indians, I think there's a strait there, so they should be able to actually do that. The Argentina war also ended, so let's quickly look. Chile is gone, unless they have some sort of island. Am I pressing the wrong button there to get my diplomatic map? So yeah, you guys can see what they took. Falkland Island, still part of the British. The Mexicans had to finish off that war with Panama, leaving them just with... I think they only started with Panama, the Panama Canal province. I don't think they're any larger than that. So yeah, the Americans just steamrolling at this point. Guess American or a Mexican stack made it through somehow. Good battle here. I think them. So what do we got? A crossing and train penalty. Americans have some shock there. Yeah, they're gonna win that. Not like last time where the Mexicans actually did win some battles initially in that Mexican war. So yeah, we've got Sri Lanka. Probably not going to last very long. Yeah, there's a strait here, so easy access for India to get to Sri Lanka, although Sri Lanka's actually already sieged out. India, I mean, the Europe Universalis AI declares these wars. They don't actually decide to prepare their army before they declare these wars, so sometimes the defender can actually get a little bit of an advantage there. This Mexican army must have some pretty good maneuver skill, because he's getting through... not getting destroyed by the Americans yet. That's kind of funny to see. Did this... Yeah, this war just ended. Alright, so the Americans didn't take as much of Mexico as I suppose they could have, but before long, the Mexicans and the Peruvians, and I don't think they're... Peru is not allied with anybody here, not allied with anybody in the world. Brazil, I'm actually a little bit surprised. Usually Brazil will get some allies, maybe even Europe. Sometimes they ally with the French, but they were actually at war with France. I think they actually lost the territory. They had taken over French Guyana here, and they look like that's been released back by somebody at some point. I did not notice that previously. So let's see, what else do we have? Italian change of government. I read that as Italian, Indian. I was going to say Italy declared war on Sri Lanka as well. Looks like we've just got these Guinean, Nigerian wars, Kenyan, Sudanese. So where is even Sudan at this point? Yeah, wow. Mozambique allied with Kenya there. So what was going on? It was Nigeria. I guess Nigeria, since they've been destroyed by Niger, is going into the Equatorial Guinea here. Now you guys like this country, Noop here. I think was there a Nope around here somewhere for a little while? Somebody mentioned that, and I remembered seeing that as well, and that was a little bit of conversation about that going on in the comments, so... This Indian change of guard, or whatever is going on between Sri Lanka, is actually taking a little while. It looks like India's finally has their army arrived, and that will be... Okay, they just finished it off, and they only took one province. That's a little bit boring. It didn't take all of Sri Lanka, it was like three provinces. And we have the Malaya here. It's sort of been waiting. They are allied with China, apparently. What government type do we have on... Yeah, so it was a constitutional republic. We've got these Chinese breakoff states here that are actually socialist as well. Qing is a merchant republic. Alright. Funny world. Some Chinese Zhuangar there as well. So yeah, just some African wars at this point. So while we do that, I know you guys liked me to... look at the European Union map. I don't really notice... Actually, wait, we had... I don't know if all of these Balkan states were in here before. Yugoslavia still exists. I know somebody said, rest in peace, Yugoslavia, but they actually are still right here. They're one province there, and they will be protected going forward, so they still exist. 2027. All right. Looks like, what was that Sudan war? They just lost out to Kenya, and this Nigerian still going on with the Congo. I guess, yes, yeah, so is Nigeria and Mali, okay. So Tome and Principe are allied there. I don't even know where that... I guess it's probably this island. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Right there is that Sao Tome there. So yeah, let's go increase our speed up to 4 since we really don't have much going on with this war. Let me just take a quick glance around the world here. Certainly not interested in that little war that's going on. You guys can have a look at the borders. Iceland, so peaceful. Danish Greenland. American Cascadia, peaceful place. We'll see if the Russians go in there. Taiwan, independent. No action in the Philippines, unlike the World War II series. Looks like we've got some rebel action in Dali as well. Surprised that Malaya... Let's check opinions as well. So they are pretty upset with Myanmar still. So I would assume they'll probably have another war here soon, but they probably had to spend a lot of admin power coring up all of the territory they captured. I mean, they have cored everything up. Okay, we've got another African war. So Chad, very, very early on, you know, is like actually very, very large, and they've lost out that territory. And now they're just feuding amongst themselves here between Chad and Sudan. and Chad took over Sudan, as you guys saw totally on there. Love the nation of Central Africa. Very creative naming there. This Nigerian war is still going on. What's that war score? Negative 43 for Equatorial Guinea. They were the ones that actually declared the war here, so actually wasn't really paying attention. Sometimes I just like read that and I don't really pay attention to who is the attacker and the defender there, so slightly peaceful world we have going on at the moment. All of our technology is pretty equal at this point. Yeah, we need another war to fire off here. That's why somebody in the comments asked me how long the series was gonna last, and I didn't want to put a concrete date on this one like I did with the World War II series, just because I think in the World War II series, in the end, it was just a bunch of only African wars, and because we have this European Union that can't really war with one another, it's leading to a very too peaceful to be interesting. We do have Switzerland here that I'm surprised has not tried to join the EU since they've been cut down to size, and I'm surprised that fact that they're still around considering that fact as well. Germany obviously took over most of them, but I'm surprised that Austria or Italy hasn't finished them off. Do they have any allies? They have an ally in Hungary, so not too much. Let's look at some alliances, though. Libya, Ethiopia, Egypt, Saudi Arabia. So yeah, even the Middle East is a little bit peaceful right now. Until I'm hoping I'm like gonna jinx it and we're gonna get some good war to fire off. Everything. I think the main players are all in sort of a truce timer right now. Like the guys who have been aggressive so far. The USA really expanding itself. They are allied probably, yeah, with Canada. I figured they would be. Allied with anybody else? No, they are not. They probably do guarantee the Israel, though, here. Which Israel, I thought they were actually gone, but it looks like they've got one province. We've got another. Oh, okay, here we go. Malaya is a change of government. Myanmar, Great Britain. That's an interesting alliance there. Philippines, so there's some Philippines action. We're gonna slow this down slightly and see what happens here. Yeah, I like these Malaya, I like what they're doing here. We'll see if they meet up with the Indians at some point and who is successful there. They both have very large armies, so either one could win, and I'm sure both of them have some very good land army tradition. I mean, they've got 2-star generals. It's not like we're one star is like some of the nations out here. This war could be very quick. We've also have a Russian. Ah, here we go. So Gazi Kamuk, Armenia, Circassia, Iran. It's actually a good one because Iran's pretty good size army against Russia. And somebody was saying that, and I actually never played as Russia in the extended timeline, but that they do have the quantity ideas, and that is just not a good idea to have for them, because the, you know, you can have this massive army, but an army that's like half the size with a good general will take you out. So this is our war we've got going on. Russia going to Gazi Kamuk. So like I was saying earlier, I don't think the Russian, where's their army? A little bit there, one stack, but so they declared this war, but their army is basically over in China. So at least we're getting some good stuff going here. Gazi Kamuk. Yeah, just like 0.7. Here we go. We've got that 37k stack. But the Iranians, I thought I saw, I don't know where they went, but I thought I saw a larger Iranian stack. I mean, we got a 20k there, but I thought I saw something like a 50k. Maybe that Iranians, I mean, they lost a lot of troops in that Indian-Iranian war. And maybe Gazi Kamuk can win this and gain some territory. Even Namibian and Botswana war, we won't really pay attention to that too much, but Namibia and Mozambique against Botswana, Zimbabwe, and Malawi. Okay. But yeah, good stuff going on in the Caucasus region here. A lot of action. We did see that the Turks, in a previous episode, did try to go into Georgia, but with Georgia was then allied with the Iranians, so I thought, you know, that the Turks could win that war, but again, they've got quantity ideas, and they ended up losing that one. Yeah, I don't think anybody really recommends to take quantity ideas. It depends on which country you are playing as in the base game, but strongly advised against, you'd rather go with quality rather than quantity, in my opinion. Turkish change of government in Iran. So I think Iran is really struggling. Turkey is allied with Ukraine, so that's a big one. They were allied before, but the Ukrainians did not join that war. So very good action all in here. So we've got... yeah, the Iranians must be struggling. Let's have a look if we can find them on our armies here. Yeah, 15k manpower and only 25k actual army left. So let's actually just sort these and look here. Yeah, USA on top, Russia, India, China, Malaya. Is the British not even on here? Okay. Ah, okay. The Russians, looks like they quickly finished that war. Took a little bit of Gazikamuk, but not as much as I suppose they could have. So we'll see how that... I think that the Turks here probably would have been in better shape had Russia continued that war. But I wouldn't be surprised if Russia still has some war exhaustion problems. I mean, they had those few wars and they actually ended up losing those, and losing increases your war exhaustion more than winning it does. So Malaya losing a battle here against Myanmar, or actually they were, but Myanmar is actually has a terrain penalty. Malaya's coming back. It's going to be a decisive one in the history of this battle. I'd like to see Malaya establish some territory in the Philippines here so that they can then basically get easy access through all of the Philippines. That'd be pretty cool. But I don't expect that to happen. Do they? Can we see claims? No, I don't think we can really see claims at this point from the diplomatic map, only if they were not at war. So, wow, we've got something huge going on here. Turkish change of government in Iran, we know about all that. Russian reconquest, so Russia against... why would Russia even declare this war? Against Ukraine, Bulgaria, Greece, Poland, Germany, that's not good for the Russians, Austria, Belarus, and Turkey. So basically Russia's taking on the European Union, so wow, wow, that is insane. Insane? Why would you do this to yourself, Russia? I mean, it's one thing if the European Union nations declared war on Russia to do this, but this seems like a very, very unwise decision. Who is your president? Stanislav Solitikov, okay. And I guess he's, even though he's a master diplomat with a diplomatic 5 skill, he's not a very smart man. We'll see. I've called these wars wrong. I was saying... we had those punitive wars against China. I was like, these aren't going to go anywhere. And then look at what happened to China, where they got cut down to size. Really did not expect that. Yeah, looks like the... couldn't tell who won that battle between Ukraine and the Russians there. I think the Russians did because they have higher morale. Insane, though. Like, wow. Yeah, I was saying, though, that the Europe might be a little bit boring with the EU, but luckily we have Russia in here to really make things interesting. So considering that the Turks here should have easy access into Iran, I would still say it looks like they've lost some battles, and it's not going so hot for them. We've got... I couldn't tell who that was, actually. It was, like, Hungary, I think. I know I hovered over it, said Hungary, but I saw a different flag. It might have been... no, it wasn't Belarus. Not sure who that, what flag that was. Somebody obviously in that war. I guess we could check back over here. I think it was, yeah, Hungary. That's who it was. Some of these flags start to look the same when I'm looking at them. Ukraine, Saudi Arabia has joined this Turkish war, so I don't know if they're going to have access into... They basically need military access through Iraq, and then they can get in here. Yeah, we've discussed this before. Okay, they look like they've got military access into Iran now, so that should be a tide turner. Yeah, they've got some armies up here. Very good stuff. All right, well, actually, it does look like we're out of time for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, please hit the like button. Really helps out the channel. And I will see you guys next time.